Day-to-day operating work processes continue to represent a major part of non-profitable expenses for businesses. Companies are under pressure to reduce costs, improve productivity, and increase customer service levels. Transaction automation technology has the potential for dramatic process improvements to change the economics of your back office or shared service operations. So what is it? Joe Basalla is Chief Operating Officer at Corbus.
It really involves the ability for a client to look at their day-to-day processes that are currently manned and staffed by human beings and understand where are the inefficiencies that exists within those processes, and what are the opportunities for technology or process to be implemented to take the place of those, you know, I hate to call them mundane, but let's say low-value processes that are embedded within the day-to-day life of their people. And then what transaction automation really means then is taking that savings that you have achieved by elimination of those low value added processes and investing that in something else, investing that in, you know, cross-selling or upselling, investing that in customer satisfaction, or taking it straight to the bottom line in a lot of cases, as many CFOs would like to do.
Is it too simplistic to say it's machines taking over from humans?
I don't think transaction automation implicitly means that. And the reason is this, because I believe that in every person's day-to-day activities, there are things that are repetitive and there are things that are value add. What transaction automation is really doing is trying to eliminate those repetitive things that stop you from really executing the high value added activities that drive cost savings, that drive revenue, that drive customer satisfaction for your organization. So transaction automation is not a replacement for people. I view it as an augmentation for people.
What are the key challenges facing CFOs when trying to reduce spend on non-profitable expenses?
What we're hearing in the marketplace is that CFOs, as well as the rest of the CXO suite of our clients, continue to be interested in reducing costs throughout their organization. But the other things that are kind of overlooked are the ability to then take the savings that we would help you generate as part of optimizing your processes and implementing technology within the order processing realm and invest those back into your business. And what I mean by that is taking those time savings, those cost savings, and applying that to improving customer satisfaction, applying that to improving your vendor satisfaction, applying that to cross-selling and upselling. There's a lot of hidden gems that can be achieved because you become more efficient, because you remove the mundane piece of your business and get your people to focus on the higher value aspects of their day-to-day job and how those higher value activities that they can work on can generate additional value for you.
What kind of trends are you seeing as firms attempt to transform their business processes?
What we found is that most of the analysts, if not all of the analysts, are saying that within the next 5 to 10 years, the outsourcing model is really going to become obsolete in a lot of ways, in that technology will now be the replacement factor rather than a human being the replacement factor. And so we've taken the trend of technology automation and transaction automation and applied it to the order processing and the supply chain processes within your organization. So we've identified the processes that are associated with, you know, placing an order, placing a requisition, collecting cash, you name it, anything that's involved in that order to cash cycle. And we've done our best to automate that. And we have pre-configured ways of addressing that and expediting that for your organization.
Is automated transaction the future? Will businesses lose out if they don't go down the autonomics outsourcing path?
I think they will under-optimize the results that they can be achieving and what their competitors are doing. The key to me isn't just taking cost out of your organization. Every executive has to do that on an ongoing basis no matter what. So those are just table stakes. That gets you to the game. If the key is what you do once you achieve those cost savings and you improve your processes and eliminate the waste from your processes. The key that we want to help our customers identify is how do you make your customers more sticky? How do you make your vendors more satisfied? How do you keep them from defecting?
So the holy grail then for CFOs is cost savings, productivity, asset optimization, and customer satisfaction. But can business processes ever achieve this?
You know, if you look at these processes as standalone processes, you kind of are missing the whole big picture. A lot of these processes interact with each other. For example, many times orders are faxed in, and a person will come and they will take that fax and they will key it in. That's a very inefficient process. We've put technology in place to eliminate that process, probably to the extent of 95% to 98% of the time. Then we take that information, which we know is of high quality, and we flow that information into the next process, which could be validating the order. And we've also optimized that piece of the process with another technology that enables you to quickly identify areas of problems and escalate those to the right people, the right available people to answer those questions and expedite the order. So, and if you add all those things together, instead of saving, you know, 5% or 10% of the time as you would by looking at individual processes, by synergistically adding them all together, we're looking at saving 40% to 50% to 60%, sometimes 70% of the cycle time being reduced through the introduction of transaction automation, as we're seeing.
Okay, well, as a vendor in a crowded outsourcing market where service providers are marketing themselves as offering real long-term value, how do you guys stand out?
We're picking our spots where we believe we have exceptional expertise and we have exceptional capabilities. We want to help our clients, not just with, you know, the order-to-cash process, but throughout their entire supply chain. We've identified numerous processes, as I mentioned earlier before, anything from creating a requisition to creating an RFP to analyzing the results from RFP. All of those have repetitive things that happen all the time that can be automated. And we've gone through the process of identifying those, figuring out how to automate them, automating them, building an asset so that we as Corbus have something that our competitors don't. And that's been there, done that, we have it done, we have an asset ready to go. I hate to use the word turnkey, but it's kind of like that, is that we can come to the table with a more pre-configured way of doing things that expedite results for our clients.
So what innovative approaches are you seeing among the companies that you're working with? Who's doing well?
I can tell you that the companies that are doing this well and the companies that are talking about wanting to do this are in the Fortune 50. They are companies that are the leading CPG companies in this world, consumer packaged goods. They are companies that represent technology companies or high technology companies. They are companies in the aerospace world. And they're also companies now that we're seeing in the retail space that are focusing on, you know, on the numerous consumer transactions they have, how they can better optimize those.
So what about the perceived risks around autonomic computing? Will it offer new ways of securing systems? There are also concerns over additional security challenges and reliability testing.
We take a very systematic approach when we talk about transaction automation. Our methodology is really develop the hypothesis, diagnose the issues, pilot those issues, and then scale those issues. During the diagnosis and piloting phase of our process, we identify the risks that you mentioned. We identify what the security areas are. We identify when there are areas when a human must interact. And there are certain processes that either required by the government or required by the customer themselves where a human being needs to be identified. And there are areas where we need to validate data. There are areas where we need to make sure the data is secure, that we have PII data properly kept, and that it's not available you know, to any person who may be trying to reach that in an unauthorized way. So by taking a piloted approach and then scaling very quickly, we minimize on those risks. We try to identify those and solve those up front before we apply to the entire process.